Morning, and welcome to the celebration of the Eucharist. Our celebrant this morning is Father John. In this Mass is being set for today, James Castelli. Please join me and rise in the entrance antiphon. This holy man fought to the death for the law of his God. It did not hear the words of the godless, for he was built on solid rock. Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. You have followed my teaching, way of life, purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance, persecutions, and sufferings, such as happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra, persecutions that I endured. Yet from all these to the Lord delivered me. In fact, all who want to live religiously in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. But wicked people and charlatans will go from bad to worse, deceivers and deceived. But you remain faithful to what you have learned and believe, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for reprobation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent and equipped for every good work. The word of the Lord. Our responsorial song. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law.
O Lord, great peace have they who love your law.
Though my persecutors and my foes are many, I turn not away from your decrees.
O Lord, great peace of faith and love your law.
Permanence is your word's chief trait. Each of your just ordinances is everlasting.
O Lord, great peace of faith and love your law.
Princes persecute me without cause, but my heart stands in awe of your word.
O Lord, great peace of thy head, who love your law.
Those who love your law have great peace, and for them there is no stumbling block.
O Lord, great peace of thy head, who love your law.
I wait for your salvation, O Lord, and your commands I fulfill.
O Lord, great peace of thy head, who love your law.
I keep your precepts and your decrees, for all my ways are before you.
O Lord, great peace of thy head, who love your law.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus was teaching in the temple area, he said, "How do the scribes claim that the Christ is the son of David?" David himself, inspired by the Holy Spirit, said, "The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand, until I place your enemies under your feet." David himself called him Lord. So how is he his son? The great crowd heard this with delight. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, it is another day the Lord has given to us, and we are thanking him for giving us good health, for keeping on protecting us. As we know, there is a lot going on. We are in the middle of the pandemic of coronavirus, and we are in the third week now, coming back to the church, resuming our schedules. As we know, we are now living in a different way. As we are reminded always to put our masks at all times while we are at the mass, and as we can see, we have those spots of social distancing. All of this makes us have a different way to go in our faith. And it has to be a part of our struggle in our journey of faith. This is quite a new way, a new lifestyle, but let us keep on asking God that we may go through this, and that the faith of all the believers and our own faith may remain steadfast. It is our opportunity to encourage one another. As we have been hearing this letter of St. Paul, the second letter he wrote to Timothy, knowing that Timothy was in that challenging environment of faith, where he was facing some persecutions. Now we had him encouraging him. We need also to encourage our brothers and sisters who are in different challenging situations. We had Paul today, the first reading, telling Timothy that those who believe in Jesus Christ firstly, persecution and suffering. Why is persecution and suffering? Because the ruling class, the Romans, did not like to hear the gospel that Paul was preaching. St. Paul was preaching the good news of Christ. He was preaching about justice. He was preaching about peace. He was preaching about love. This gospel is the same gospel we need to take to the world. The world today needs this gospel than before. We too will experience the same. Perhaps people will not like our lifestyle because of what we are or what we believe. Those are sort of persecutions in our present time. St. Paul gave encouragement to Timothy to stand steadfast in his faith. He reminded Timothy that every faithful person will experience trials of some sort, giving an example of himself. Paul, while he was in Antioch and the other communities that he faced so many persecution, and he said, he endured all that. He did not run away. He remained in that faith. My dear brothers and sisters, they remained faithful. Some died martyrs like St. Boniface that we are celebrating today because of what they believed. We have to learn from all those first believers. We have to learn from the martyrs like St. Boniface, who lived his life faithfully, became a missionary in Germany there, a monk, and founder of many churches. He experienced hardship, persecution, and he died as a bishop, as a martyr. We too, in our present day, perhaps, we may die in a different way. Let us stand firm. St. Paul is giving tips to Timothy to make full use of the scripture, because the scripture is inspired by God. He is telling him to use strategies of the word of God to preach, because it is useful for teaching, for the refutation of some false doctrines. And the scripture is also very good for correction, rather than correction. The scripture is also very good for reconciliation and healing. Look like what is going on now in our country. We need to use this message of the scripture for reconciliation and healing those who are wounded in one way or another. The scripture is used for training and righteousness. Any good student of the scripture must know this part of the scripture. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10 to 17, the basis and the use of scriptures. Do we have our Bibles at home? Yes, I think. Do we open them at the time of trial? At the time we want to correct somebody? Do we make reflection? You know, many times, long time ago, many believers believed that the scriptures were set apart for priests. This is before the first, before the second Vatican Council, and that the Bible was reserved for priests and deacons, and it was a sacred book not to be used by anyone else. But nowadays we have all of this in our church, freedom to use our scriptures. Let us make full use of the scriptures. In our daily prayers, perhaps once in a week, you can gather with your family, choose a certain passage of the scripture if you want to correct somebody or give healing, and reflect. And in that, it will give inspiration. It may not give the answers, but inspiration. It may change those who are in the moment of despair and distress. Let us now turn to the Father with confidence as we present our prayers and petitions.
That the Church may be filled with the knowledge of God's will and all spiritual wisdom and understanding, let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord may grant all nations prudent and compassionate leaders who strive to work together for the good of all, let us pray to the Lord. That those who suffer for the sake of the gospel may find consolation in God's promises, let us pray to the Lord. That we who gather around the Lord's table may receive the grace of God's call to a deeper sense of holiness, let us pray to the Lord. That those who have died may share in God's gift of eternal life, let us pray to the Lord. And for those whose names are written in our book of petitions, and for all the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts, let us pray.
Lord God, you sent your Son to bring us life. Hear the prayers we place before you today. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, if you regard for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual food. Acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar, on the memorial of Saint Boniface, Bishop and Martyr, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations, may give honor to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed Mother, Saint Boniface, poured out like Christ is to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and of the feeble bestow our strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord, and so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy, holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and gave him thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat. eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when Supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from me, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have paid your worth to be in our presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and together our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And also, we pray that in the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may meant be for us eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as our way the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us acknowledge our willingness to be peacemakers. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Please join me in the communion antiphon. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me, says the Lord.
A polite reminder for all of us to receive Holy Communion in our hearts, thank you, and maintain the social distancing spots. And elector Mark, and request you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that following the example of St. Boniface, Bishop and Martyr, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace.